And folks, you're walking around in the mall, stop where you are, because you are going to see something that I guarantee you will never see anything like this again. If you're at home, sit down with the popcorn, because ladies and gentlemen, I present Jeffrey with his dance interpretations. Jeff.
Thanks. Finding a girlfriend. I'm good shape, sturdy build, all solid. Love show business, love movies, cameras.
Tell us about Gumby.
Huh?
Tell us about Gumby.
I have a Gumby in the window here. I have two more inside. You know, real nice, you know. And have lots of that too, inside here and outside. And it's a lot of fun, you know. It's a nice instrument if you'd like to come inside and give a look.
I haven't wrote it into music yet, but I will. Little Jeffrey lives in a little Jeffrey house. With a little kitchen and a little pot. Jeffrey cooks his dinner, makes him nice and hot. Little Jeffrey lives in a little Jeffrey house. With a little kitchen and a little room. Little kitchen and a little pot. Cooks his dinner, makes him nice and hot. It doesn't mean much anything, but it just, sometimes around your house, you just sing, you know, or just some things come to you. It's not even a performance song. It means very little. It's very simple. It's very nonchalant.
But right next to the keyboard where I take all my showers, it's in the corner of my living room. That's why I write so many songs about showers. I go in here and I take my little shower. The shower is hot and the water is running. The shower is hot and the water is running. And it's time for us to relax and get wet together in the Jeffrey shower. And see, it's very convenient being in the living room. It's a very high-tone luxury. It has its own portable curtain. It closes and opens and opens and closes. And I feel very refreshed in the shower. It'd be nice to have a companion to take a shower with. I wrote a shower song in February 1989. It was a very rich recording session here in my living room. It's called Jeffrey Shower. It's a very exotic song. Shower is hot.
I like writing shower songs, but then I felt I ran the gamut because how many more times can I say let's get wet together? How many more variations can I do? So I figured the shower songs had it now. They had their run. It's getting old, but then just when I think it's getting old, things work in opposites with me. Then I got some new ideas for some future shower songs like Shower Mate. Jeff got wet in the shower.
Performance art is very exciting. I like to dance and create new visions of myself. that I think of in my own mind. I get very excited when I get on the stage, just dancing to that music. I'm influenced by the different strippers and go-go girls I had seen. They just had a very comical air about them, even though they were trying to be sexual. They were really very much theatrical, very comical, the way they would try to bump and grind. And, you know, that's the way a lot of dancing is, and I just love to do my dance. And if, you know, I have different moves, you know. I like to move around them. This is one move. It's an easy move to do, you know, different moves as you dance around. You know, dancing should be graceful, isn't that right? And then let's see if I can dance to my own playing. I'll create my own. I like music. I feel dancing should be theatrical. It shouldn't be confined to just doing 1, 2, 3 steps. Sometimes it's theatrical, it's leaping across the room. It's interpretation. I enjoy it a lot. Music means a lot to me. It's a form of energy, and dancing should be free. It's just something I do. People have influenced me, like the movie Fame, that movie Leroy was doing a dance where he stroked his rear end. That's where I got that idea to get to the more risque elements of it. But it's not really risque, it's just a form of exotica. And then the other movie, Flashdance, gave me some more ideas, and some of Jade, even though I'm not a fan of Janet Jackson, her videos were very good videos. And those media images, plus the biggest influence in my dance, believe it or not, were the strippers at the Trot Burlesque Theater. You're from Philadelphia, you remember the Trot. I mean, sure, they were stripping, and it wasn't certainly culture, but there's a certain amount of coyness, even though it was overdone, that was very amusing, just the little things they do. And if you notice the way a stripper dances, or choreography, or even now they have male strippers, there's something very comical about it. Basically, I'm grateful to live in Indiana. I would like to say this, the business community here has a very poor attitude. There aren't any decent stores, and they insult the consumer by saying shop Indiana first. I say shop Indiana last. Boycott any merchant that supports this inflammatory shop Indiana first. They say our residents are spending money buying exotic goods at Monroeville Mall that they could have bought here. Well, that's their right. The customer comes first. If you don't have what the customer wants, that's okay too. Then they're going to go somewhere else. And but I love Indiana, you know, but it doesn't mean I love everything about it. No place is perfect, but I think Indiana's a good place to live. Not a great place to shop, though.
The malls make it very easy to shop, and it's also very mind-expanding because you don't have it all in front of you. I go there, I make no bones about it. I'm a music collector. I'm going there to get compact discs. And if I get a compact disc, I feel I've accomplished something. Then you have a nice lunch.
Would like to find is someone. I'd like to have a nice girlfriend, someone to go out to dinner with, to the shopping mall with, and I'd like to get you to know me better, which you can write to me at the address after the film if you're a female. Age is unimportant. 18 and over is fine. About my dimensions first, I'm broad-shouldered, have my own teeth, have my own hair, good shape, sturdy build, fine young buck, fine. Look at the good, I'm good, very good. And my dimensions, I have a nice body, and I have a nice mind. Spiritually, I'm very deep. I'm into miracles, getting miracles, but very down to earth. I love music, love soul music, funk, jazz, no rap, sorry, urban contemporary, no. Like, I really enjoy being with someone. I'm very lively and open. I hope I got some mail today. Gosh, maybe I'll find a girlfriend in the mailbox. Oh, shit, there's no mail. Gee, I do all the work for my singles club. It's all right for me to be out on the front lines, putting in the ads and everything. Then I come home to my mailbox, I don't get the finished product. This is what I get. I'm okay. It's good enough for me to be on the front line. This is the mail I get. Ames. I never shop there. The record department sucks. I told them to stock more CDs. It's a drag. I mean, you know, this is how I get off. You know, there's not many social outlets for a single in a small town. I mean, gee, if I lived in Bucks County, I'd put a personal in, I'd probably be flooded with letters. But at my post office box where I put my independent personals in, I get lots of answers. I practice here at Coswell. It's very inspirational. Some people ask if I'm allowed to practice here. I've been doing it since 77. I'm not going to ask any questions now. I paid for it. It's not free. I pay taxes. I paid my dues, and it gets me off. It's a very creative environment. A lot of my songs were written here. This is how I'll write a song, you know. And as far as food, we were taught Giant Eagle has food half price after 8. Their chicken, everything makes you shit, you know, not real good. But the lasagna and the pastas are good, and you can save money. I mean, you don't have a lot of money to go out and spend if you're a student or intern. So, I mean, Giant Eagle, for $3, you can eat so much, you know, you'll shit afterwards, and you got your good deal, you know. So it's basically a good thing. And Indiana's a good town. We have Cogswell Hall. It's a very inspiring place where you can practice and create your own reality, or if you want a if you want an altered reality, that's okay. I'm not, you know, a lot of my songs deal with altered reality. Well, I had this little Gumby like this. This isn't the original one. It was on a keychain, and it fell beneath the nightstand, and Grandma found it for me and says, "This is what you're looking for," and I wrote a song called Grandma Found Gumby. That's how it started. And then the reason I bought a Gumby doll was because my brother's girlfriend, who he was living with, had a Gumby doll, and they were so adorable. I had to get one for myself, and that's why I wrote so many Gumby songs. They have a very cute texture about them, and there's just something very lovable and innocent about them. Now the big thing is Bart Simpson, but I think Gumby's just much more lovable. I just enjoy it. Sit down here, Gumby, relax. Don't get uptight. It's just a camera. Oh, stop fidgeting around. Gumby, I mean, we're on camera. Don't make a schmuck out of yourself. Just sit there and relax. And then little Gumby will sit here. I have big Gumby and little Gumby. I have two Gumbies. It's nice, isn't it, Jeff? Yes, Jeff, I think it is. That's good, Jeff, that you enjoy doing these things.
Tell us where you think you got your musical talent from.
From nowhere. I just had a desire to write songs like my friends, and so I took piano lessons. But my relatives must have been inherited in the blood, because my aunts and uncles sang a little bit, very comical. My Aunt Eva and Aunt Molly were very comical. Must have been ordained, preordained, you know. And, about a Gumby is you can bend it, shape it, and manipulate it. Dogs crap all over the floor, and you have to clean up after them. And I stepped in some dog crap in front of a neighbor's house, and it was really a drag getting dog crap on your shoes with the Gumby. Look, no rectum, no anus, doesn't shit all over you. Have fun with it. How do you feel about that Gumby? Gumby's the most adorable thing. Say hello, Gumby. Don't be shy. Hello, everybody. Jeff's my best friend. I like Jeff. And I like Gumby, just wonderful, you know what I'm saying, just absolutely wonderful, you know. I have a friend called Gumby. I have a friend called Gumby. Doesn't crap on the floor.
I used to be in the early days here, I used to play piano out there and entertain the residents. I even danced for them, but some nurses complained. They thought this dancing was too much or wasn't appropriate. But, you know, it seems the administration has one view. To them, I was different. But I remember that old lady that used to clap along with me when I would dance. So I ministered to some people. But they don't want to deal with someone that's different. Entertainment I found very political, even when I was asked to dance at the Deaf Awareness Day two, three years ago at Indiana Mall. I got mixed reactions. Some liked it, some don't. some of the feedback is, well, they didn't know whether to laugh or not, so they didn't know whether it was comedy or not. I don't label things, I do it. That's their problem if they don't know what to do. You know, I'm not, even someone asked me, do I do a comedy act? I don't say, well, I'm doing a comedy act. It is comical, obviously, but I'm not going out there where I'm going to do a comedy act. You know, that type of thing.
Hello, folks, I'm Jeffrey. I'm going to play some songs for you. Hi, everybody. My first song I'm going to start off with is a song about police brutality I wrote in 1986 called When the Billy Club Comes Down. A song that treats police brutality as a fact of life, which it really is. This is a rough song. I hope you're a liberal audience, you know. When the Billy Club comes down, it hurts like a mother. When the Billy Club comes down, it hurts like no other. Policemen try to crack open my head. Crack it so hard, make me wish I was dead. Ain't that a mother? Ain't that a mother? Fry those racist pigs. Power to the people, can you dig? Get the policemen out of the schools. Nobody's playing us for fools. We must see a brighter day. Here it comes, it's on the way now. Coming right on now. You've been wonderful. I'm not done yet, you know. I'm just getting... It's the first time I played here standing up before they put a table around and I sat down, but I like standing up. It's like being on a rocket ship or something, you know, like you're controlling a panel, you know, like you're in orbit. This is a new song I wrote over in Cogswell, and it's an instrumental. It's a time to be spiritual, so let's get spiritual here. This song is called Astral Project. It's a... You know, where you know, the high cost of gas today, out-of-body travel is good because you can travel into someone else's body and they can travel into yours. That's called astral projection, you know, and save some money on that gasoline, you know.